Hey guys, Rivers here with some cool tech, and today I want to show you what's on my Android mini PC. So first off, I'm running the Minix Neo X7, and I use this guy a lot because it's got some of the best hardware and software available for a mini PC right now. I'm also using a custom ROM on the X7, and it's called the Quickshot V2 by the Nitro team. And this guy is basically a tweaked version of Minix's 008 firmware. They've got some new apps and some other tweaks on here that make it just really awesome. Of course, the 008 firmware is really good too, so this is just a little bit better. First up, it's full 1080p, whereas Minix's ROM was 1080p on the videos and 720p on the UI. This guy's 1080p all the way around, so it looks just really crisp in the UI, which I really like. Also, the Quickshot ROM is not only available for the Minix X7, but also the X7 Mini. I'll put a link to both ROMs in the description down below, as well as links to the X7 and X7 Mini, and all other software and hardware you see in the video. So the next app I want to talk about is Next Launcher 3D, and that's the UI that you're looking at right here. It gives you these large icons, and it makes all the desktop transitions 3D, and makes it easier to move icons around, and things like that. I use a lot of different launchers like Go Launcher, Go Launcher HD, Nova Launcher, SPB Shell, but I like Next Launcher the best. Right now I'm running a theme on here called the KitKat Experience, and you can see it right here. It gives you a couple hundred KitKat icons, and I think they look really good. Oh, by the way, the wallpaper I'm running is called Asteroid Pack, and it's by Maxilis.net. Costs a couple bucks in the App Store, but it's probably one of my favorite live wallpapers that I've ever downloaded. It's got a whole bunch of customization that's available. And next up is one of my favorite Android apps of all time, it's Dolphin Browser. And Dolphin Browser is nice and fast. I'd say it's faster than Chrome, plus it's got the options for plugins, which come in really handy. So I've just installed a few plugins, but there's actually a whole lot more available. Like here, for example, you've got desktop mode, so when your web page loads and it's all set up for a cell phone, you can switch it over so you can have a desktop view of that same web page. And here's a screen cut option, so you can take a screen capture or just a section of the screen if you want to. And you can just save this, or you could actually just send it out onto, like, say, Facebook, or share it out in a text or something like that as well. You can also save the whole web page to a PDF, or you can put a theme on the browser. And here's one I like, is night mode, because I like to read my Galaxy Note a lot in the dark, and the screen just is a little too bright when it's dark. It kind of just burns your eyes out. So put it in night mode, and it's a lot easier on your eyes when it's late at night and you're trying to get some reading done. Okay, next up, we've got what's called Custom Nav Bar. That's this guy right here that gives you these icons and stuff down here. And these, what it does is basically let you overlay icons and even widgets on your taskbar. So this is a Poweramp widget right here, and I just put it on the taskbar so I can reach down here and hit play on anything I want to whenever I want. Works great, and it's super configurable. So we can put whatever widgets we want on there. We can move them wherever we want to. I mean, I could put it right on top of this other stuff if I wanted to, and I can adjust the size of it if I want to. So I think it's a couple bucks for this app. Totally worth it if you want to just go minimalist. You wouldn't even have to have icons. You could just put a few things down here that you use all the time. Highly recommend it. Stable too, works great. Okay, I'll just go down the list. So next we'll try MX Player. And MX Player works excellent for playing videos on the X7, especially with this ROM. And I have to say, this video on here is silky smooth. I have not seen any skipping at all with this software on this ROM. So I'm very happy with the video quality. XBMC is also included in this ROM, and it's the Minix version, which works great on Minix players. Not quite as good as MX Player for just straight video playback quality, but it's right up there. It's working no problem on 1080p video now. Okay, so next up we've got Appy Geak, and this is like a news reading app, but it lets you pick a category, and then it gives you news from all different websites on that category. So say you choose you want all the news from Smartwatch. Let's go to Smartwatch, and it's going to pull news from all the different websites and put it all into one place. So it's just really easy to get news on whatever category you want. So this is my favorite news app by far. And of course, you got staples like Netflix, which is just, everyone's got to have it. It's a great app, and it's looking like it's got a better picture now, too, on these 1080p kernels. And finally, we have this app down here called Home Switcher. And what this does is let you select which launcher you want to have as your default launcher and clear out old default launchers. So I can go into, say, the Next Launcher, and I don't want that to come up every time I hit the home button anymore. and I just choose clear defaults, then I hit home, and I can choose a new launcher and choose to always open with that launcher if I want to. And I know actually Minix is really good with their ROMs, and they have a setting in the display settings to do that also, but a lot of Android mini PCs don't have that, so it's nice having that home switcher app. Okay, another must-have app is called EX File Browser. This app just rocks, like it lets you make shortcuts on the desktop, so I got a shortcut to my videos right there. Go right in there and I've got all my videos, hit one click and play them in MX Player. And let's just take a look at some of the stuff I have in the folders here. So Amazon App Store gives you a free app every day. This App Brain Market's kind of useful sometimes to see like your app history. This is the top apps, which is a nice app to have. You can see what's popular, so you can find free apps that way, like when they come out on App Gratis and stuff. Chives, nice little eye candy there. Media players, so here's all that I use. Arcos Video. Doggcatcher for MP3s. That one is awesome. Highly recommend it. It lets you download it all for offline use. You just automatically download while you're in your Wi-Fi if you want. And let's see. So like Pocket Now is probably my favorite Android podcast. I like a lot of Adam Carolla, and I like me some Eddie Ifft. This guy is hilarious. Just filthy and freaking hilarious. So anyways, there's just a few of the stuff. Mostly it's on my phone. I don't listen to it too much on my Android mini PC. And let's see, Netflix, Poweramp, I bought the full version of that. Well worth it though, just kick butt app. Skype's nice to have. Wallbase, this is where I get a lot of my wallpapers that you see. I always have different wallpapers. Gives you nice high resolution, really crisp wallpapers, so it's pretty badass. Highly recommend Wallbase. And let's see, XBMC comes built in. It's a Minix version, so it works well on here. And utilities, you're probably familiar with this if you see my channel, but I use a lot of Antutu, a lot of the CPU-Z. Let's take a quick look at that. So there's some of your processor information, and you can see it is a full 1080p kernel right here. That's nice to have. And of course, Linpack. This guy's a nice one if you want to get some YouTube videos for watching offline. And oh, this guy, Ultimate Backup, so you can back up your apps. If you're rooted, you can backup up the apps and your settings of the apps, and they use this a lot to transfer to the next Android mini PC when I get one, so I don't have to spend all the time typing searches in the app market. And you basically go there, back them all up, then find the folder using ES File Browser, copy that to your SD card, because it on these Android mini PCs it thinks your SD card is the internal memory. So go there, copy that, copy, paste it into here. And then when you get a new one, you copy it back over to your SD card, or back over to your internal memory, and choose restore, and it'll put all your apps onto your new Android mini PC. And by the way, I do not endorse stealing any apps. This is just to transfer apps you own. You could just easily go into the market and get them. And I definitely wouldn't recommend stealing apps anyways, because they're written in JavaScript and people can just decompile it, add in their own malicious stuff, recompile it, and then you've got a stolen app that's basically gonna wreak havoc on your life. So I would not recommend doing that at all. And you know, buck, you spend a buck or two and you enjoy it for like the next year. I think it's well worth it anyways. Oh, another nice thing that's on this guy is, okay, if you have the A2 remote, there was a problem where it would always default to the audio coming out of the remote. Well, that is now at the bottom here, so it will default. It'll just stay on whatever you left it at, and when you reboot the device, it'll go back to that. Okay, the only problem I ran into with this ROM so far, and it's pretty minor, is if you go in settings, there's nowhere to set the screen timeout. It just times out after about 3 or 4 minutes, and then you have to move the mouse around. It takes like 10-15 seconds to come back on, and that's not ideal. So you can, the only workaround I got for that was go into developer options and just stay awake. So it just stays awake all the time, basically, this way. So you can just go back and switch between it if you want it to go to sleep mode, because I'd like it to go to sleep in about 15 minutes is what I would really like. But that's the only problem I found. Other than that, this thing is super solid. Haven't had one lockup, one reboot, anything. Okay, and for my image viewer, I use this app called Quickpic. It's really highly rated if you look in the App Store, and it's just a good app. It loads super fast all your thumbnails, and it's just robust, so it's a good app. But what I want to show you is, okay, say I'm going to save the wallpaper, set as, okay, so I'm setting the wallpaper and Quickpic, and look what it does. It does this, all the apps do the same thing. It zooms way too far in on your wallpaper. But now we can fix that, because thanks to FreakTab ROM developer Snake Killer, he gave me this hint about this app called Wallpaper Wizardrii. And so you go, same thing, I'm still in Quickpic, and I'm gonna set it as, but I'm gonna use Wallpaper Wizardrii this time. Watch this, this is just cool. Does such a good job. Well, it's a little buggy, but the end result is what you want. So there's different options. You can stretch it to fit, you can crop it exactly. I'm gonna just use landscape crop. It's gonna crop a little bit off just depending on the dimensions of your picture. And bam! We finally have a fix for the wallpapers not fitting to the screen on these Android mini PCs. And it's a free app if you don't mind having a few ads in there, or you can pay for it if you want to get the ads taken out of there. Oh, and by the way, I just saw the Minix Firmware 009 became available today for the X7, but I'd probably wait on it and just make sure they get all the bugs worked out, because this ROM is working so well. Why not use something that you know works great? Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed the little peek into the different apps that I run on my Android mini PCs. And again, I'll put links to everything you saw in the video in the description down below. And remember to subscribe to my channel if you want to see the latest Android mini PC reviews as soon as they are released. Also, like me on Facebook, because I give advanced notice there when I have a new video about to be released. Plus, I post the latest news there as well. Thanks for watching, and as always, aloha.